Hey, let's welcome back to the show from House Judiciary, Congressman Jeff Van Drew. Congressman, it's good to see you again. Happy Friday to you. Okay, let's get right at it. You guys are planning full public hearings for the Biden impeachment inquiry. You know, that transcript of Hunter Biden's closed-door deposition is out. The media has been downplaying it as no, they're there. But we're finding he admitted he did put his father, Joe Biden, on multiple business calls with Hunter's overseas business associates, that he did admit he did fly with then-Vice President Biden on Air Force Two to China, where Joe Biden met with Hunter Biden's business partners in China. So what do you make of the media coverage here and Hunter denying that his father was ever involved?
Well, the media coverage is weak. Let me tell you, if this was a Republican president and that was his son, there'd be a whole lot more you'd be hearing about, and there'd all be all kinds of accusations and editorials going on. You know the reason. All we ask is for the media to be fair, and unfortunately, sometimes they absolutely are not. There's a lot there.
You know, Congressman, you just take, you know, the way to look at it is just take out the names Hunter Biden, take out the names Joe Biden, and when you look at the details, the allegations of corruption are pretty stunning. There's pushback, you know, saying, you know, where's the smoking gun? Hunter Biden testified he did get millions from China, including a diamond. Joe Biden has been denying that. He did say that Joe Biden did have lunch with Hunter's Kazakhstan oligarch business associate at Cafe Milano. And Hunter's former business partner, Rob Walker, testified, yes, Joe Biden did show up at the Four Seasons restaurant in D.C. to meet with the chairman of the Chinese oil and gas firm that Hunter was working with.
Look, and we know this all to be true. And what's real interesting about this, Liz, is Devin Archer and Rob Walker, business associates of them, have a whole different story about how much Joe Biden, and they've testified as well, was involved in this. We know that he was involved. Let's face it, Joe Biden was the merchandise, and, you know, Hunter Biden was the salesman. And who gets paid in diamonds, by the way? When's the last time somebody gave you a big diamond as payment for something?
I'm talking never. Okay, so the other thing, too, is what did you make of Hunter Biden testifying dozens of times he didn't recall events? He also testified, he basically was drunk, not sober, probably high, when he sent that WhatsApp text message to a Chinese business associate in July 2017, demanding the Chinese pay up millions of dollars, and that he was sitting next to Joe Biden. But he's saying he was drunk and high at that time.
Well, that's the excuse he's going to use. So we're supposed to feel bad that he's so drunk and so high and so out of it, he doesn't remember. And the words he liked to use is, I don't recall. The bottom line is, he was involved in a lot of real questionable activity. And, you know, the whole Biden family, whether it's money from Kazakhstan, Russia, China, Ukraine, Romania. Again, how many times are you getting checks from countries? How many the Americans that are watching the show right now? It doesn't happen. This is weird stuff. And let me tell you, this is bigger and badder than Watergate ever was. These are real issues. We've got to bring them out, and the American public deserves to know.
So we're hearing $24 million the family made, including things like selling access to the government, selling the Biden family brand name, selling influence. Is it more than that?
It could be. We know at least $24 million for sure. That we have documented. That we can see. But, I mean, it's all so weird. I mean, even think of the transactions with Jim Biden. Same thing. The whole family.
Congressman Van Drew, have a good weekend. We appreciate you coming on. It's good to see you again.
Always good to see you. Thanks, Liz.
Same here.
Keep going.
We have